Before we dig into the camera, perspective, viewport awesomeness that is the rest of this lesson, let's learn one more shape that Shape Renderer can make for us. Circles, also partial circles or arcs. We're going to explore some more code in the course repository. You can load up this project yourself and follow along. To dig in, let's check out the to-dos. Here's the most basic circle you can draw, specifying the x position of the center, the y position of the center, and the radius of the circle. And there we go, it's beautiful, right? We can also draw a partial circle, or an arc, by specifying the number of degrees counterclockwise from the positive x-axis that the arc should start, and how many more degrees it should keep going from that point. So this line is 45 degrees from the positive x-axis in the counterclockwise direction, and then 270 degrees is 3/4 of a circle, so we get this Pac-Man shape. Circles have a dirty little secret, though. They're not really circles. They're a fan of triangles, where all their triangles have their points at the center of the circle. Shape Renderer will pick how many triangles to use so the circle looks smooth. But if you make super small circles, it might choose to use too few. This optional last parameter sets the number of segments to use. Let's see what happens when we set the segment count too low. If we set the segment count too low, we end up with a circle that looks like a stop sign. This can also happen if you're drawing very small circles, but you're zoomed way in on them. Circles can be drawn using either shape type filled or shape type line. The latter draws just the outline of the circle. If we want to draw both solid circles and the outlines of circles in the same render callback, we first need to end our filled batch and begin a new batch in line mode. Let's give this a try. There we go. A circle drawn in line mode is just the outline of the circle. Let's try something crazy and draw some target rings. Bam, there we go. We can also draw just the outline of an arc, just like so. And if we draw the outlines of a bunch of arcs stacked up on top of each other, we can draw some funky snail shell-like thing. Remember, if any of this seemed too complicated or went too fast, don't just take my word for it. You've got all this code sitting on your computer, so check it out and play with it yourself.